The halfway point for Season 9 of Fortnite Battle Royale is approaching pretty quickly here, as Week 5 of the season is only a few days away at this point. And with nearly half of the season already over, we are rapidly approaching the massive plot twist that is going to unfold in the final weeks of the season, where the Fortbyte image is finally going to get revealed, and we'll also get our very first glimpse at the ever so elusive Utopia skin, which will undoubtedly give us a ton of information regarding Season 10 and the storyline transition that will lead up to it. For now though, we already have a ton of info in the form of various leaks and rumors regarding what could be happening in Season 10, including the potential end of days for the Fortnite Island, alongside the reveal of one of Fortnite's biggest secrets. All of that and then some we'll be discussing here today as we take a look into the future towards Fortnite Battle Royale Season 10. What's up guys, and welcome back to the Simply Fortnite channel, and thanks for stopping by. If you're new here, feel free to subscribe with your post notifications turned on, and if you enjoyed the video, don't forget to drop a like rating on it. And now without further ado, let's take a look at some brand new Fortnite Season 10 leaks and rumors. For starters, just in case you might be new here, as of right now we know thanks to the PlayStation Store that Season 9 of Fortnite Battle Royale should be ending on Wednesday, July 31st, meaning Fortnite Season 10 should be going live for everyone on Thursday, August 1st, pending any potential delays or issues that arise in the time in between then and now. Of course, Fortnite seasons do always go live on Thursday though, so that lines up there, and according to that date, Season 9 will actually end up lasting 12 weeks in total, which is 1 week longer than normal, and while Week 5 will be the halfway point for the storyline progression depicted through the various loading screens that we unlock along the way, Week 6 is actually going to be the official halfway point for the season. On top of that, if Season 9 does end up lasting 12 weeks in total, there is a pretty good chance that we could end up seeing the overtime challenges return and give us the ability to unlock a free Season 10 Battle Pass, so definitely stay on the lookout for that stuff. With that out of the way though, let's jump right into what people are saying about Season 10 so far. And our first big topic of discussion today, of course, has to be the Polar Peak / Greasy Grove event that is currently unfolding before our very eyes, as if you end up wandering around near the base of Polar Peak, you might actually hear the cracking and creaking of the iceberg as the volcano eruption damaged the base, meaning sooner or later, the iceberg at Polar Peak is going to come crashing down. And judging from the location of the volcano's impact, if and when the iceberg comes crumbling to the ground, it's pretty likely that the frozen lake is going to be left in shambles, and perhaps Greasy Grove could once again become a point of interest on the map, which I think a lot of people would be very, very excited about. Now, there's not a ton of information going around right now regarding the Greasy Grove event since it is in its very early stages, but we do know that at least one of our major one-time events this season is going to revolve around Polar Peak, and probably a large chunk of the iceberg biome as well, seeing as Polar Peak is currently one of the highest and largest things on the map. So, when it breaks, there's definitely going to be some catastrophic changes made to the island, specifically around the iceberg biome area, and of course, as more information surfaces about that, we'll be filling you guys in, so make sure you're subscribed for that. Another major point of focus for Season 10 also lies in the Fortbytes, since those are actually going to be our main source of information leading up to the official Season 10 reveal. Of course, Fortbytes are a brand new feature here in Season 9, and they essentially replace the role that weekly challenges have held in the past as far as unlocking the secret skin goes. Of course, the weekly challenges do still exist and they are necessary for unlocking the storyline progression loading screens, but for our secret skin, this season we are going to have to unlock and discover 90 individual Fortbytes in order to unlock that super secret Utopia skin, which, like the Visitor, Enforcer, Aim, Fire King, and Ruin skins all did in the past, will likely give us some major hints at what events are going to unfold at the end of Season 9 and also at the start of Season 10. And going off of the previous season's track record, it's likely we'll end up getting another major one-time event at the very end of the season to cap off the Season 9 storyline and lead us into Season 10. Essentially, it'll be like a whole finale once again, kind of like what we had with the volcano eruption last season. Anyways, as of now, we are unsure if the Polar Peak and Greasy Grove event is going to span throughout the entire season and that's going to be the actual finale event, or if it's going to be something that occurs sooner than that. But as of right now, the Fortnite image does not seem to be hinting at any kind of iceberg event, so presumably we could actually be getting two separate one-time events this season, one relating to the iceberg in Greasy Grove, and the other relating to the bunker that Bunker Jonesy escaped from in the Season 9 intro cinematic. Judging from the Fortnite image, Bunker Jonesy is the main character involved in the storyline, and we've even seen some hints at a potential Kevin the Cube return as well, but let's be honest, when you hear the word bunker, what is the first thing that comes to mind? That's right, the Wailing Woods bunker, or as it should now probably be known as, the Jungle Bunker, since that same old mysterious bunker still, to this day, has never been opened and has never been removed from the map. Let's be honest, Epic Games is a developer team that does everything for a reason. So many little secrets that we've seen in the past that we thought meant nothing at the time turned out to be a teaser for a future item or a new feature or even a new event, so undeniably this Wailing Woods or Jungle Bunker has to mean something. And since bunkers have been such a hot topic as of lately, with Bunker Jonesy emerging from one in the Season 9 intro, I have a feeling everything might come full circle at the end of Season 9. I mean, just think about it. The volcano area has been turned into a pressure plant, and that bunker just so happens to be located right next to the volcano and Sunny Steps. Perhaps the inner machinations of the islands could actually be found inside of this bunker, and whatever is actually underneath the volcano in Sunny Steps, which is presumed to be ancient and all-powerful, could actually be discovered if the jungle bunker were to be opened up. Just saying, the bunker is there for a reason, and one of these seasons, that reason is finally going to be revealed, so why not during Season 10? Lastly, today, the final big rumor we've got to touch on is of course one that may make some of you really happy, but also might make some of you very worried because it has to do with the Fortnite Island's life, as it honestly could very well be coming to an end. Just taking a trip down memory lane here, the island has nearly been destroyed by a rocket, it's nearly been destroyed by a random purple cube named Kevin, it's nearly been destroyed by an ice king set on ruling the world, it's nearly been destroyed by a massive earthquake and volcano eruption, and at some points in the middle of all that, there was actually a game file pertaining to an evil army of robots actually destroying Tilted Towers. Now that is a lot of catastrophe to undergo in a pretty short span of time, and what I'm really getting at here is that there is only so much the Fortnite Island can take at this point before either the entire island is completely different from what it was on day one, or the island in and of itself just completely gets destroyed and we get introduced to a brand new map to play on. Regardless of your thoughts and feelings on the situation though, you have to admit, the thought of a new map is intriguing to say the least because we don't really know what Fortnite would be like on a different map. We honestly haven't even left the Fortnite Island ever, except for briefly, and I mean very briefly, during the Butterfly event and also the Unvaulting event. So what if come Season 10, since 10 has always been a very notable and like milestone number, we actually end up getting a brand new island and a brand new map to play on? It'd be pretty wild to say the least. Wild is definitely an understatement there. On top of that, we do also know that there is an entire world outside of the Fortnite Island that is functioning and living. We've seen multiple characters come to the Fortnite Island from an outside location. For instance, the Ice King, the Enforcer skin, Blockbuster skin apparently came from outer space. Like, there's a lot to the Fortnite universe that is yet to be discovered. Question is, when will we actually discover that outside world and outside universe for ourselves? Is that ever going to be a battle royale thing? I'm thinking if it is, Season 10 would be the perfect time to introduce that. Anyways, on that bombshell and with that being said, that does effectively wrap things up for today's video. Be sure to let us know down in the comments below what exactly you think is going to happen in Fortnite Season 10. Let's see if any of you guys can actually predict Season 10 in our comment section down below today. Of course, if you guys enjoyed today's video, be sure to drop a like on it, give it a big old thumbs up, as it would be much appreciated. And if you are brand new here to the Simply Fortnite channel, feel free to subscribe with your post notifications turned on, that way you'll always know when a new video goes live. Of course, by clicking that bell icon and thus joining the notification squad, every single time we post a new video here on the channel, YouTube will actually send you a message and let you guys know that we've gone live. That way you can be the first person to watch, like, and comment on each and every new video. Once again, thank you guys so much for tuning in, and until next time, take it easy, have an awesome rest of your day, and we'll see you guys on the Battle Bus. Peace out.